Okay, let's now consider how errors propagate through our calculations. What I have here is a cube where I've measured the height, the depth, and the width. So the height is 7.1 with some error, which is 0.1 of a centimeter. The depth is 3.5 plus or minus 0.2 centimeters, and the width is 4.0 plus or minus 0.1 centimeters. And what we're going to do is calculate the volume. So the volume of this thing, and we'll do what you might consider. It's just the base times the height times the width. So that's 4.0 centimeters times 3.5 centimeters times 7.1 centimeters. Great. And you can plug all this in your calculator, and what you'll find is that the volume should be 99.4. And the units, we have centimeters times centimeters times centimeters, so we have centimeters cubed. All right. Now this is the volume, but there's some uncertainty about the volume. What is the error of this number? Like how well do we know that how accurate do we know this? So we need to figure out what the error is in the volume, given the errors in these measurements. So the first thing we're going to do is calculate the maximum possible volume. And this is when we take our measurements, we take the maximum possible measurement in the range. So in the case of the width of 4.0 plus or minus 0.1, the maximum width is 4.1 centimeters. The maximum depth is 3.7 centimeters, and the maximum height is 7.2 centimeters. Now, when you do this calculation, you get a maximum volume of 109.2 centimeters cubed. Okay, so how do we use this information? Well, we compute the uncertainty of the volume. That's this delta V here. And the uncertainty is just the maximum volume minus the volume we calculated previously. And in this case, it's the 109.2 minus 99.4, and that is just 9.82. And I've dropped the unit somewhere along the way, but it should be centimeters cubed. So that's our uncertainty. So we can express our volume as 99.4, that's the first value we got, just by multiplying just by computing the volume the normal way we would. And we have to add and subtract our uncertainty, which in this case is the 9.82. And our units here are centimeters cubed. Okay, and I'm going to write this in proper form. In proper form, I only express the error to one sig fig. So I have the 9.82. This actually rounds up to 10. So I have plus or minus. I'm going to write this as 1.0 times 10. And I can't do any better than the 10th place here. So actually 99 actually rounds up to 100. So I'm going to write this as 100.0. And that's all times 10, and I have centimeters cubed. There we go. That's our volume. And how the error propagates in our calculation, and how we can figure out the error in our result. Now, let's do something more with this. Let's say we've weighed this cube, and we found its mass. So let's say M is 6.3 plus or minus 0.1 kilograms. And we want to find the density. So density, if you don't know, is just mass over volume. So in our case, we can actually just plug in some numbers here. We can take the mass to be 6.3 and the volume to be the 99.4 we got before. We could use the 10, or rather the 100 here, but let's use the 99.4 for now. So we have 99.4, and I believe you should get 0.0636. I'm hoping I've done that right. And the units, so in our numerator we get kilograms, and our denominator it's centimeters cubed. So our units for density are kilograms centimeters cubed. Okay. Now, there's some uncertainty in the density, and we're going to try to quantify that. So let's compute the maximum density given the mass and the volume that we have. So again, we want to maximize density, and density is a ratio, mass over volume. To maximize a ratio, you want to make the numerator, so that's the m, as large as possible, and the denominator, which is volume, to be as small as possible. So, with the numbers we have, the maximum mass is 6.4 kilograms, and volume, the maximum volume, well, it's the 99.4 plus, oh, sorry, we want the minimum volume. The minimum volume is 99.4 minus 9.82, and that's 89.58. Okay, and I believe, and now I'm hoping again I didn't do this wrong, is 0.0714 kilograms per centimeters cubed. Now, if for some reason these two numbers aren't exactly right, feel free to correct them and work out the actual answer. But let's just go with these numbers for now. Okay. By the way, why I'm saying this is I'm terrible with using a calculator. Now, we can compute the error delta P, which is, or delta rho, sorry, which is rho max minus rho, and that's our 0.0714 minus 0.0636, and that's has units of kilograms per centimeters cubed. And when we plug those numbers in our calculator, I believe we should get, I don't know, let's calculate. It's 0.0714 minus 0.0636, and that is 0.0078. So we can write our density as the density we computed up here plus or minus the uncertainty here. So we have plus or minus 0.0078 and 0.0636, and our units are kilograms centimeters cubed. And finally, in proper form, our error gets written to one significant figure, so it's 0.008. I round it up, and I can't do any better than that accuracy. So that's three digits after the zero, so that's 1, 2, 3. So my density can't be expressed any better than 0.064. I round up because of the 6 here, times kilograms centimeters cubed. Good. So that's how error. This is a great example of how errors propagate through our calculations. Be careful when you're maximizing a ratio. Make sure you keep the numerator as large as possible, the denominator as small as possible. And you always compute your uncertainty as the maximum minus your average value. Thank you.